My name is Vera Windhagen. I'm a designer and I'm part of the new European Bauhaus team of the European Commission. And I will tell you a little bit about our journey of the first phase of this new European Bauhaus initiative from the European Commission. I will give you some snapshots. I will say something about the way we did this first phase. It's about co-creation, community building, and delivering a project under a lot of pressure. So the first thing about co-creation. Exactly 1 year ago, the president of the Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, mentioned a sentence in her State of the Union speech. And she said, we will set up a new European Bauhaus as a co-creation space where artists, architects and students, engineers, everybody basically would work together to make this new European Bauhaus happen. And it was meant to give people hope after the pandemic and work on the recovery. And this project is part of the new European deal. And one of the commissioners said last week, if this climate package of the new European Commission would have a soul, the new European Bauhaus is a little bit the soul of this Green Deal package. And it's meant to be to make all our climate measures tangible. And the first question that we asked in co-creation is people, how do you want to live together? How do we want to live together in the future in Europe? So instead of what public organizations normally do is they come up with a plan and they decide this is the plan, and then they consult their citizens or stakeholders. And what we did is we did it the other way around. So we asked people right from the start of the initiative last year, after the State of the Union speech, we started and we asked people, how do you want to live together? So we immediately, instead of coming up with a plan, we started asking people what they wanted. And what made it different is that we started with the three basic values of the new European Bauhaus, which is sustainability, making things beautiful, aesthetics, and inclusion. So those are the three basic values. And we asked people, what happens if you put these three values together? And we asked people to organize or set up conversations themselves with multidisciplinary teams, just like the old Bauhaus did 100 years ago. That was a movement where artists, architects, craftspeople, everybody got together. And because of this cross-fertilization, people actually gained new knowledge. So this is what the only thing that we asked. So we asked for input and we asked people to organize conversations and share those conversations with us. And for this, we had a toolkit and a template where people could upload on a website that we created their results. And normally, if you have a consultation, we get a lot of opinions in the commission. But now we asked for good examples, ideas and visions, and challenges and needs. So we got a lot of response. In the meantime, we started an Instagram page. We are very active on Twitter. We have our own website where everybody could upload their ideas last year. And we have a newsletter. And these dates, the figures that you see on the screen are a little bit outdated because we have now more than 14,000 followers on Instagram. More than 20,000 people have subscribed to our newsletter. So we have a lot of followers, which is quite new for a topic like this inside the European Commission. So we engaged a lot with our audience. Also this week, we will launch our first prize ceremony. So we wanted to showcase all the good examples that are already there, because if we have learned one thing during this year or half year that the co-creation phase was open, is that there are so many good examples already out there. So one of the challenges that we had is sharing those good practices that are already out there and also building on them. So you will see from the 16th of September onwards, you can see who has won our new European Bauhaus Prize. And there are 20 prizes to give away. So these good building on these good examples, those stories, the challenges that people saw, we collected in total about 2,000 good practices, and a lot of expertise and experts joined the conversation. Who has answered of all the people that we had? Well, the funny thing is that we reached an audience that we usually do not reach. For example, we have almost half of the audience that we reached are architects, designers, artists, and also activists. And next to a whole range of mix of audiences, as you can see. So that was already quite a success for us to reach a different kind of audience than more traditional stakeholders that the European Commission usually reaches. We try to make sure in this whole co-creation process that we were mixed, so that we got replies from all over Europe, and you can see the bigger countries sharing a little bit more than smaller countries, but everybody shared. And what you do not see in this picture is that we also got a lot of contributions from outside Europe. So we really realized that this is not only a European movement, but there are a lot of good practices globally available. So we need to have a global debate. And what struck us in all the replies that we got is that we have a lot of good practices that come from a very local level. So very local level examples were shared. The funny thing is, working in this way is not something that people expected from us. So the biggest challenge throughout this whole co-creation process was to get other more traditional institutions in. And the picture that you see on the screen is a picture of the friendship group that the European Parliament has started. And especially in the beginning, it took us quite some time to convince also our normal stakeholders to go along with this new kind of process, because everybody started asking us, what are you going to do? What is your plan? And we said, well, we want to hear from you what we should do and not decide upfront what the new European Bauhaus should be. So I'll quickly share a little bit of the first findings, but you will see that this week we have a communication document with all the results coming out, and also with all the steps of the next phase of this initiative. But a couple of striking things. So like I just said, we got a lot of response from small initiatives that see the local value, so the value of specific initiatives in a local place. It could be about buildings, so people giving examples on how to build in a different way, how to build more sustainably, but also how to work together in a better way, or how to organize things with the neighborhood in a better way, even talking about a social economy, a new kind of economy. What struck us more is that in the initiatives that we saw, people were already working in multidisciplinary and integrated ways. And this seems to be one of the success factors to innovate in the local scale, that you bring different kinds of people together. So children with universities, or anybody, artists with scientists. It's the mix that makes things really new. And then, as I just already said, we got just as many things on bouwen, the Bauhaus, on the built environment, but also on social structures, on really intangible things and values on how we want to live together. And the last thing that really struck us is that when we asked people how the Commission could help, people said, yes, it's funding, but maybe more than funding, we're actually also looking for access to networks more visibility, more knowledge sharing. So it's also a lot of, it has also a lot to do with giving people visibility. So in this course of this year, we have really built a community of people that believe in this idea of a new European Bauhaus, a way to live together that is more sustainable, more inclusive, but also beautiful. And for this, we asked a lot of people, organizations, nonprofits to become partners. And the only thing we asked our partners in return is if they would organize meetings, conversations themselves. And this is what they did. We had a lot of response, and about almost now 700 partners applied, and we accepted 270 so far to join our initiative, join the movement. And you see a big set of logos on the screen, and the application is still open, and it will be open in the next phases as well. And the funny thing is, we organize meetings with all our partners that they also start to link up together, so they start to see the common ground between all of them. And also in this sense, we did not give a specialized set of partners a preference, but we asked a very diverse range of partners to the floor. So we have very local organizations, but we have also global organizations that joined us. So locally working on one place, for example, in the north of Spain, but then also global networks that have a global outreach. And it's the mix between them that makes it so interesting, and the conversations that they have. So delivering under pressure, it's almost unbelievable that exactly 1 year ago, the last State of the Union speech was there, and there was only this one sentence in the speech of the President of the European Commission. And now we are 1 year further. It means that we had to work in a very almost startup-like mode. We had a small team, but we had to work very closely together with all the other services of the European Commission. So you see here a little bit on the screen, one of our planning setups that always got messed up because new things would come up, or we decided to organize things in a different way. So that was really a challenge, but it also worked quite well. So what did we learn from this 1 year? So as the New European Bauhaus is a multidisciplinary, transdisciplinary initiative, we also put our team together in a very diverse way. So we are very diverse people. But we made it work because we constantly worked on our team development, and we created a safe space where we also could have our internal discussions, for example, on what the best ways to proceed would be. Then we had our own way of working with hierarchy and cabinets, which is a European Commission way of saying how did we work with the traditional organization. So we had, of course, our official ways of doing, so the reporting, jour fixe meetings, so the more official meetings. But we also had a lot of unofficial meetings where we really invited also our hierarchy, so top management, in to join and see and have a peek behind the screen on what we were doing. And this is also something we did with our other directorates. So we work inside the Joint Research Center, which is one of the small directorates inside the European Commission. So we work with all the scientists of the European Commission, but we worked also with all the other ministries, as you can say, from the Commission, in a formal way, but also in an informal way. So what's next? As I already said, there will be the launch of the prize in this week, there will also be the new speech of the president, the State of the Union speech, and there she will announce a part of the next steps of the new European Bauhaus. So this was only the first phase. The next phases are still to come. And it's a challenge to work on this, but it's also a great privilege. Thank you very much. This is my presentation. Thank you.